कराते कराते उनको कलसी सोने की कलसी में ठंडी पानी में अगुर कर्पूर चंदन डाल रहे, इतने स्नान इतना स्नान कर जगन्नाथ जी से बुखार हो गए। जगन्नाथ जी आज बंद है ना दर्शन नहीं दे रहे, जगन्नाथ जी बुखार जगन्नाथ जी दर्शन नहीं दे रहे, जगन्नाथ जी बुखार है। बुखार होने पर जगन्नाथ जी को बुखार नहीं, भगवान थोड़ी बुखार होता है, वो तो नित्य सिद्ध उनको क्या बुखार है, लेकिन वो बुखार की बहाना बनाए, बुखार की बहाना क्या बनाए, जो बुखार नहीं वो अंदर में जो लक्ष्मी है वो रहते हैं लक्ष्मी के साथ में द्वारका में, इसलिए लक्ष्मी को केवल 15 दिन के लिए वो मनाते हैं, पास में रह करके सर पर हाथ रख करके शरीर में हाथ रख करके मनाते हैं। देखो हैं मेरे 1-2 दिन के लिए छोड़ दो, मैं जाऊँ कहाँ पर वृंदावन में जाऊँ मिल करके आऊँ, केवल वो मनाते हैं। क्यों मनाते हैं, जैसे एक व्यक्ति का अगर 2 स्त्री होता है, अगर अगर पति किसी एक स्त्री को बोले मैं उसके साथ में मिलने के लिए जाता हूँ, फिर पत्नी क्या बोले गुजार तो वहीं पर रहना, यहाँ आने का कोई जरूरत नहीं, वहीं रहो, जितना रोटी फेंक कर देगी मुँह मोर कर बात करे घर पत्नी को फेंक फाड़ कर देती हूँ, वो क्या दूसरे स्त्री को पास में जाना क्यों चाहते, मेरे पास में क्या किसी की कमी है दूसरे स्त्री को पास में जाना क्यों। इसलिए जगन्नाथ जी रहते हैं लक्ष्मी के पास में, लक्ष्मी को मनाते हैं कि मेरे आदेश दे दे राधा रानी और गोपियों से मिलने के लिए, इसीलिए 15 दिन तो लगता है केवल अंदर में रह रहे थे मनाते जगन्नाथ।
सो Today we have performed this Snan Yatra. So this is the day in Jagannath Puri when the Lord is brought out out in the open courtyard, and he is made to sit on a jeweled throne, and there he is given a bath. He is given a bath, and they bring a pot smell of gold, and they put camphor, aguru means fragrant minerals, etc. They add to this water, and they give him the bath of music. Usually means they give him so much bath they give him that he becomes sick. And he becomes sick, and for 15 days, like, see, he took bath in the morning and now he's sick and he's not giving darshan to anybody. He's resting now. So, he is Satchidanand Vigraha. He is the embodiment of Satchidanand. So, does he also become sick? Is that actually the confidential secret about this, his resting is that for 15 days, what he is doing, where does he live? He lives in Dwarka. Dwarka, whom does he live with? He lives with Lakshmiji. If he lives with Lakshmiji, now Krishna for 15 days, he's trying to appease with his sweet words, he's trying to please her with his sweet words, that she may give him permission, at least for 1 or 2 days, that he may go and visit the Brajavasi. Now think, there are a person has 2 wives, and one, he's telling the husband, is saying that I will go and visit the other co-wife. What will the wife do? Wife will serve you, how she will serve you? She will give you chapati like a flying saucer on your plate. Or she will look at you, she is looking somewhere else and trying to speak to you. Means in a very disrespectful manner, as if she is neglecting him. She is neglecting him. So similarly, no co-wife is happy that co-wife may also inquire, what is there lacking in my service that you have to go to her? So similarly, for 15 days he's trying to appease her. He's trying to say with her, all, see, I am all alone with you. Nobody is disturbing us. See, I am all alone with you. Only me and you. 15 days I am giving this association. Please give me at least 1 or 2 days. So this is what it means when he says that, oh, he's resting for 15 days. Actually, in these 15 days, he's trying to take the permission in an amicable manner from Lakshmiji so that he can go and visit the Brajavasis.
Yeah. कहते जो ये जो अंदर की भावना है, लेकिन जगन्नाथ पुरी में जो वो लोग पंडाल को जो बोलने वाले उनका जो बोलने का है, जगन्नाथ जी को वहाँ पर क्या करते हैं, जगन्नाथ जी को वहाँ पर उनको जैसे बुखार होने पर हम क्या खाते हैं, पतला पतला खिचड़ी खाते हैं, वहाँ पर जगन्नाथ जी को जो पांचन होता है, 5 तरह का आयुर्वेदिक मेडिसिन है, वो मेडिसिन जगन्नाथ जी को खिलाया जाता है। जगन्नाथ जी रोज अन्न दाल सब्जी खाते हैं, 15 दिन तक जगन्नाथ जी अन्न दाल सब्जी कुछ भी नहीं खाएंगे, जगन्नाथ जी कोई भोग नहीं लगता, केवल भोग लगता जैसे बुखार होने पर जैसे फल मूल खाते हैं ना, जगन्नाथ जी को ये फल मूल भोग लगता है जगन्नाथ जी को वहाँ पर 15 दिन तक, क्योंकि जगन्नाथ जी एक तो लक्ष्मी को मनाते हैं और दूसरे तरफ में वो बुखार की बहाना बनाते हैं, मेरे को बुखार हो गया, इसलिए ये 15 दिन के बाद में जगन्नाथ जी फिर नवजोवन दर्शन होता है। नवजोवन मतलब जगन्नाथ जी को स्नान कराया गया, करने से अंगराज इधर हो जाते हैं, पूरा जगन्नाथ जी को फिर नया श्रृंगार होता है, जगन्नाथ जी को फिर नई श्रृंगार जगन्नाथ जी होता है, फिर नवजोवन दर्शन होता है, होने पर फिर जगन्नाथ जी लक्ष्मी से बहाना बनाते, बोले देख लक्ष्मी 15 दिन तक तेरे पास में रहा है, कहीं तो गया नहीं। और तुमने देखा मेरे को बुखार हुआ, तुमने देखा है कि नहीं? 15 दिन तक हमने किया क्या खाए, और हमने भोजन त्याग दिया, केवल मेडिसिन खाए, फल मूल खाए, मेरा मन अच्छा नहीं लगता। इसलिए 1-2 दिन के लिए मेरे को आदेश दोगे थोड़ी सी घूम घाम कर खाओ? तो लक्ष्मी कहती है हाँ सचमुच से 15 दिन तक मेरे पास में रहे और बुखार हुआ, ठीक है जाओ। बोले कितना दिन, कब जा रहे? बोले 1-2 दिन के लिए जाऊंगा, फिर मैं वापस आ जाऊंगा। बड़ी कठिनी से लक्ष्मी किसी तरह से आदेश देती है जगन्नाथ जी को, जाओ लेकिन जल्दी जल्दी वापस आ जाना।
So this is one angle we discussed, that how he is staying with Lakshmi and in a solitary place, and he is speaking to her, trying to appease her with his sweet words, trying to get her permission. But the Pandavas in Jagannath Puri, they consider that he has fallen sick. So after taking a bath with such large, huge quantities of water, he has developed a fever. And because he has developed fever, what do we do when we have a fever? Then our digestion becomes weak. When our digestion becomes weak, then what do we eat in those times? It is described by Ayurvedic doctors, they describe that you should eat in those times things which are easy to digest, like a khichdi, which is very thin, or some fruits, etc. So all the Pandavas of Jagannath Puri, they, for 15 days, nothing is cooked for him. He is usually, you know, that how many offerings are made for him in a day. So many offerings, minute after minute, so many offerings are made to him the other days. But in these 15 days, all he is given is just some, it is described, a mixture of 5 herbs and some fruits and some roots, etc. He is eating all these in these 15 days, nothing else is offered. And Jagannath is now saying, after 15 days when he has like this, in a room with Lakshmiji, then he asks his permission. He says, "See, I became very sick. I kind of 15 days I had to stay all alone. And I spent all these 15 days with nobody else but with you. And my mouth's taste is not very good. After temperature and after eating all these this medicine, etc., my mouth's taste, I have lost all taste in my mouth. And I'm feeling very restless. I haven't gone out for 15 days. Now please give me permission. For 1 or 2 days at least, I will go and I will come back quickly." Then Lakshmiji, with a lot of difficulty, she somehow agrees. She also sees that, yes, you have remained with me for 15 days. And yes, it is true, you were not feeling well. And because you were not feeling well, you only ate some medicinal herbs. Then all you ate was some fruits, etc. So she, with great difficulty, somehow, she agrees and she gives permission to Lord Jagannath. And yes, go. But mind you, you are going, but come back very quickly. How many days you want to go? He said, "Well, just go for 1 or 2 days." He says, "Okay, come back very quickly. As soon as within 1 or 2 days, you come back."
इसलिए लेकिन वो लक्ष्मी को साथ में नहीं ले जाती। बोले लक्ष्मी को क्यों साथ में नहीं ले जाती? बोले जो ब्रज का जो लीला है ना, वो लक्ष्मी की प्रवेश नहीं है। क्योंकि लक्ष्मी को जो भाव है, जो आदि द्वारका दी राजा गिरा दे, लेकिन वहाँ पर जो भाव है, वहाँ पर तो कृष्ण को भगवान मानने वाले, यहाँ तो कृष्ण को भगवान मानने वाले, इसलिए वहाँ पर तो कृष्ण को ही सखा, अपना पुत्र, अपना प्रियतम मानने वाले। कृष्ण द्वारका में तो कृष्ण का आदेश को सब पालन करते हैं, लेकिन वहाँ पर कृष्ण सबका आदेश को पालन करते हैं। कृष्ण का नौकर यहाँ पर, लेकिन कृष्ण सब नौकर वहाँ पर सबका दास। इसलिए कभी भक्ति में लक्ष्मी का अधिकार नहीं है, वो कुछ चीज को समझ नहीं सकती है, इसलिए कृष्ण जगन ये लक्ष्मी को नहीं लेकर जाते हैं। और कहते थे कि लक्ष्मी उसको केवल 3-4 दिन के लिए उसको कुछ दे करके आते हैं और चाबी काठी पूरा ले जाते हैं। 3-4 दिन के लिए जो भोजन के लिए जरूरत होती है उसको दे करके आते हैं जगन्नाथ जी, देख करके 3-4 दिन में आ जाऊँगा। लेकिन जो जगन्नाथ जी जाते हैं ना, वो आते हैं 5-5 दिन, जो नहीं आते हैं तो स्त्री का एक स्वभाव है। क्या स्वभाव? अगर स्त्री को पता चले मेरे पति अंदर अंदर में किसी स्त्री को और प्रेम करता है, फिर तो सारा दुनिया में ढूंढा बिछड़ाने में फिर तो कमी नहीं रहती। और जिसको देखें उसको बोलते रहेगी, तो देखा जानते वो क्या करता है, वो उसको प्रेम तो करते हैं, उसको प्रेम करते हैं, उसको गीता है, तुम फायद नहीं करके करते। तो लक्ष्मी तो बाहर निकल कर आ जाती है और अपना कहते, देखो जगन्नाथ जी मेरे को खाने के लिए 2-3 दिन मिले गए, हम कुछ नहीं दिया, सब देखो सारा दुनिया आपको ढूंढा बिछड़ा कर बोलते हैं। वहाँ पर लक्ष्मी बाहर आ जाती है, फिर सब लोग लक्ष्मी को कुछ पैसा वैसा वहाँ खूब देते हैं लक्ष्मी को, वहाँ पर लक्ष्मी को पसरा फैला कर बैठ जाते हैं।
So then Lakshmiji agrees to give him permission for 1 or 2 days. So he's saying, she asks him, how many days will you go? He said, oh, I've been 1, 2, maybe maximum 3 days and I will come back. So he's taking the permission and he goes. And before he goes, he all the keys, etc., everything of all the stores, etc., Jagannath is taking with himself. And he's leaving behind for her ration enough for 3 days. Just for 3 days, he leaves the ration behind and then he goes away. But when he the question arises there, he goes alone there. He goes alone, he doesn't take Lakshmiji. A question may arise there that why is he not taking Lakshmiji with him? Because Lakshmiji is not qualified to enter the breath pastimes. Because what is the mood in Dwarka? What is the mood in Dwarka? In Dwarka, they are all queens and they live with a lot of opulence. And Krishna also lives with a lot of opulence and he is the king and there are so many servants serving him, etc. And whatever he orders, everybody listens to him. And but in Braj, it is completely opposite. He goes there, he is the servant of everybody. Everybody orders him. What relationship does he have there? Does he have on? Somebody has on reverence? Everybody in Dwarka considered him to be the supreme personality of Godhead. But there, everybody considers him to be his son. He is my son, or he is my beloved, or he is my friend, and they behave accordingly. Lakshmi will not be able to understand this behavior of Brajvasi, and that's why she is unqualified to go to Braj, and that's why he doesn't take her. So, although he has gone saying that he is going for just 2-3 days, so then, but she doesn't come back for 5 days, and he doesn't come back for 5 days, so all the ration that she had for 2 or 3 days, it is all exhausted now, and she has nothing. And then, as is the nature of the lady, suppose she finds out that her husband has love and affection for some other woman, then what will she do? She comes out and starts speaking to all her friends and to everybody she starts speaking and making a loud cry about all these activities. See what my husband is doing. He has affection for such and such person. And what did he do? Not only he went to her, he has gone there, and also he has just what he has done. He just gave me ration for 3 days. He'll say he will come back within 3 days and I have exhausted all the ration. I can't even eat now. I don't have anything to eat. I'm like a beggar now. What should I do? So it is described that Srila Maharaj is describing that at that time she spreads out her upper cloth and some people they collect money. They collect money and arms for her so that she can support herself in the absence of Lord Chaitanya.
Lakshmi.
Sorry, Lakshmi. Yeah.
फिर जब 5 दिन में जब जगन्नाथ जी नहीं आते ना उसको कहते हैं हेरा पंच अभी फिर वो आती है चैतन्य चैतन्य करती कृष्ण रस वगैरह दूसरे बहुत अच्छे तरह से उसको व्याख्या करती उसको कहते हैं हेरा पंच अभी हेरा मतलब ढूंढना वो गए तो गए 2 दिन के लिए गए तो गए ना अब तो कर रहे ही क्या ऐसे नहीं राधा रानी और ब्रज गोपी भारत अगर हमारा पति को कोई ज्यादा सेवा करके कोई ये करके कैप्चर कर वो कभी सहन नहीं कर सकते उसे ढूंढने जाते वो करते ही क्या अपना दल वर्ग को लेकर सजा भजाते जाती जगन्नाथ जी को पहिया तोड़ देते जगन्नाथ जी जो रथ होता है ना उसको पहिया तोड़ देते मतलब स्त्री जब मान करती है पति को बर में स्त्री जब मान करती है पति को घुसा करती है क्या कर नहीं कर सकती दिखा रही वो क्या नहीं कर सकती है इसलिए वहाँ पर महाप्रभु अपना परिकरों को साथ में जाकर सब देखते हैं बोले अगर स्त्री मानी ही हो पति के ऊपर कैसे चढ़ाव करती हाँ पति को चढ़ाव कैसे करती देखो लक्ष्मी जाकर पहिया तोड़ दी पूरे रथ की और जाकर वहाँ पर बैठ जाती है सिंहासन में और अपना दास दासियों का आदेश दे पकड़ पकड़ ले आओ मेरे पति 2 दिन के लिए आए ब्रजवासियों ने गोपियों ने राधा रानी उसको हरम लिया पकड़ कर ले आओ बांध कर वहाँ 2 दल होता है एक लक्ष्मी के दल और एक राधा रानी के दल लक्ष्मी के दल जाकर भी जितने वहाँ पर पंडे हैं ना जो सबको गले में रस्सी बांध कर जैसे कि पापी को खींच कर ले जाती है ना गामछा बांध कर ला कर लक्ष्मी को पैर में पटक देती है और वो लोग कहती हैं हमारी गलती हो गया आप चिंता मत करो लक्ष्मी आप संतुष्ट हो जाओ गलती हो गया जल्दी से जल्दी जगन्नाथ जी
का स्वर्ग में जाएंगे
After that,
when she's with enough with all her patience that she could muster in this difficult situation. So then she decides enough is enough and she has to go. Because a woman, when she understands that some other woman also has affection for my husband, then she begins to think. And sometimes, most of the time, she overthinks that maybe she's serving him more than me, and she's trying to attract him. She's trying to, like he's used the word, maybe she will gobble him up. She will swallow him up. Swallow him up means that she will totally take him away from me. So, like this, thinking like this, and she manifests a beautiful, she means takes a beautiful chariot full of so many wonderful jewels, decorated with so many jewels, and she herself decorates herself very nicely with very opulent clothing, with golden embroidery, etc. Embroidery made up of gold and very opulent chariot. She goes along with her followers, etc. And she says, she orders all her followers, go and capture everybody. It is described that when she reaches there first, where Lord Jagannath has left his chariot, first thing that what she does is, she breaks the very chariot wheel of the chariot on which he came there. It is described that a well of, like Shakespeare is describing, hell hath no fury as a woman scorned. So similarly, because she is feeling neglected, she becomes so angry, she becomes so annoyed, she breaks the, Krishna Thakura Goswami describing in Chaitanya Charitamrita all these pastimes, that how Lakshmiji has come, and she is ordering all her maid servants, go and capture all these Brajvasis. There he was sent here with the permission of 1 or 2 days, and they don't want to keep him here. And they now, they go and they have gamchas, means the upper crop they have, and they pull him, pull all the pandas there, they put the upper cloth in his neck, and they pull him. That's like the young dudes are pulling the sinful people by the noose and taking away to the hellish planet. Similarly, all these people are brought and they are thrown at the feet of, at the mercy of Lakshmiji. And then they fold their hands, all these, the mandas, etc., they beg forgiveness from Lakshmiji. They said, oh, you do not worry. Very soon, Lord Jagannath will follow you and he will come very soon and back again.
Isliye, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, apna bhaktam ko saath mein, उसे लीला दर्शन करने के लिए जाते हैं। जब दर्शन करते हैं उस समय महाप्रभु बैठ बैठे सब कुछ देख रहे हैं। हाँ, स्त्री जब पति को कर भूषा करता है कैसे क्या करती है, और वहाँ पर महाप्रभु का सब साथ में श्रीवास पंडित नारद, फिर इस तरफ दूसरे तरफ स्वर्ग दामोदर पर ये ललिता, कहते ललिता कौन, बोले ये ब्रज के परिकर, बोले ये श्रीवास पंडित कौन, बोले नारद, बोले ये किसका परिकर, बोले वैकुंठ के परिकर, नारायण के परिकर। इतने में श्रीवास पंडित स्वर्ग दामोदर को देख रहे हो क्या हो रहे हैं, देख रहे हो लक्ष्मी का क्या ऐश्वर्य है, क्या वैभव लक्ष्मी के देख रहे हो, हैं वृंदावन में क्या कुछ है नहीं, पेड़ पौधा है, वो लता पता दो चार फूल फल, और क्या है वृंदावन में कुछ नहीं, हमारे देखो लक्ष्मी की क्या हीरे जवाहरात, क्या उनकी ठाट बाड़, तुम्हारे कुछ नहीं बेकार तुम्हारे वृंदावन है, वृंदावन विकास देख रहे हो कैसे लक्ष्मी की है, लक्ष्मी के गण कैसे राधा है, जो ब्रजवासी गण कैसे कपड़ा पकड़ कर फेंकते थे जाकर के लक्ष्मी जी चरण में देख रहे हो क्या, ए वृंदावन में कुछ नहीं लता पता। उस समय में स्वर्ग दामोदर के बोले चुप रहो, बोले तेरे को पता नहीं वृंदावन का ऐश्वर्य क्या है, वहाँ पर एक पत्ते में इतने शक्ति है कितने तुम्हारे जिसे वैकुंठ को प्रकट कर सकती है, इसलिए ब्रह्मा कहते हैं चिंतामणि प्रकर सदमा सुकल्प वृक्ष, वृंदावन में जो भूमि वो चिंतामणि, पानी अमृत, कोई चलता है लगता है, नृत्य करता है, कोई बोलता है लगता है, गान करता है, हैं इसलिए तुम पता नहीं वृंदावन की भूमि की महिमा, वहाँ पर तो ऐश्वर्य माधुर्य वगैरह रहता हुआ रहता, बोलो मैं तुमको पता नहीं वृंदावन में क्या ऐश्वर्य है।
So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is coming to this place and he is watching all these pastimes. He's sitting there along with his associates, he's watching these pastimes with his own eyes and he's relishing these pastimes. He's deciding that how, who is there now? In his associates, there is Sarup Damodar, there is Raya Ramanan. Who is Sarup Damodar? Sarup Damodar is Narada Muni. And Raya Ramanan is Lalita Shakasati. Sarup Damodar is Lalita and Shivas Pandit is Narada. Jyotpandit is Narada, sorry. And he's saying that who is Lalita Sakhi? Lalita Sakhi is the associate of Radharani. And who is Naraji? Naraji is the associate of Lakshmi. And now they have a big quarrel. And now Naraji is speaking to Shaka Sakhi that what opulence do you have? Look at the opulence of my Lakshmi. Look at it. See what kind of chariot she is riding. See what kind of opulent clothes she is wearing. See how wonderful jewelry she is wearing. See how she is decorating herself. And then Belthasakhi, Vishakhasakhi, they are replying to him that you better keep quiet. You do not know all this opulence that you have, your Lakshmiji has come with. Every single leaf of the trees that there are, every tree is a Kalpa Vriksha, wish fulfilling tree. And every leaf of this Kalpa Vriksha is capable of manifesting hundreds and thousands of Vaikuntha, which have more opulence than all this opulence that you have brought. So like this, they have one very beautiful arguments, etc. And like this, Mahaprabhu is watching all these arguments of, and is enjoying relishing all these aspects.
जगन्नाथ जी आते हैं रथ को लेकर के लक्ष्मी का जो दासा दासी जहाँ करके छत ऊपर देखती है, जगन्नाथ जी धूल उड़ा करके, जगन्नाथ जी अपना रथ को साथ में तीनों भाई रथ को उड़ा दी, धूल उड़ा करके आ गई, कितनी लक्ष्मी ऊपर ले जाती देखने के लिए कहीं जगन्नाथ जी आते हैं। बलदेव सुभद्रा के पति देव आ रहे, लेट के जाते जाते जब जाते हैं जगन्नाथ जी वहाँ पर सोने जाते, सोने की यात्रा होता है। जब जगन्नाथ जी अंदर में आते हैं, जगन्नाथ अंदर में लक्ष्मी आ करके दरवाजे को बंद करते, एकदम दरवाजा बंद कर देते हैं, बल्कि जो उनको घुसने नहीं देते। लेकिन सबसे पहले बलदेव प्रभु आते हैं। जब बलदेव प्रभु आते हैं तो लक्ष्मी प्रश्न करते हैं, दासी कौन आ रहे हैं? तुम्हारी जेठ आ रहा है, लोहिया जेठ, इसको मतलब दरवाजा खोल। उसको बाद में आती है सुभद्रा, बल्कि तुम्हारी नंदुरते, लेकिन जो जगन्नाथ जी आते हैं घुसने मत ये ताले को घुसने मत दिया। परसू बोल कर बरसू हो गया, अभी तक आप पंद्रह दिन बाद में आए, तो बंद कर दो घुसने को, घुसने नहीं चाहिए।
So then he's describing that how after all these arguments, counter-arguments between Radharani's and Lakshmiji's associates, then Prabhu Jagannath finally decides to make his return to Dwaraka. And now when he's returning, then immediately all the maid servants of Lakshmiji, they see that, oh, the chariot, they can hear the chariot, and they can see the dust rising on the horizon. They can understand that Lord Jagannath is returning. And immediately they inform Lakshmiji, and all of them go up on the roof of the palace, and they see from a distance the chariots are coming back. So the chariots are coming back, and what does she do? Lakshmiji, she goes and locks herself in her room. She goes and locks herself in her room, and then first Baladevji comes, Balaramji comes, and then he knocks at the door, and she asks, who is it? He said, oh, Baladevji has come. Baladevji, she has no arguments, nothing against Baladevji, also in relationship, also he is to be honored. He is the elder brother-in-law, so he has to come. He said, let him come. So he is allowed in, and then after that, Subhadraji comes. Then again they ask that, who is coming? Who is knocking? Subhadraji. He says, Subhadraji. He is saying that Subhadraji is a very sharp sister-in-law, not an easy person, very sharp sister-in-law, and she has a very sharp tongue, etc. So she has nothing against her also. She lets her also come in. She's allowed inside the palace. And then finally Lord Jagannath comes. And Lord Jagannath comes, and he also knocks at the door of the palace. Who is there now? It is Jagannath. And he said, let this black person remain wherever he had gone. Let him go back wherever he had come from. He said he will come within 2-3 days, and years he has spent there. Why do they want to come there? So like this, he's not allowed inside. She doesn't allow him.
जगन्नाथ जी को जो बंद कर देते ना, लेकिन जगन्नाथ जी कृष्ण तो चलिया है, हैं? कृष्ण तो चलिया है, इसलिए वो जो ब्रज गोपियों का जो मान है, राधा रानी का जो मान है ना, फिर तो मान भी बहुत तरह का है, लेकिन कहते राधा रानी का जो मान है ना, दुर्जय मान, मतलब तो जिस मान को मनाना इतने आसानी बात नहीं है। कहते कृष्ण 10 तरह से जब राधा रानी मान करती है, कृष्ण कितना कभी श्यामा सखी का रूप, तो कभी बट्टू ब्राह्मण का रूप, कभी चूड़ी बनाने वाले रूप, कभी चरण दबाने, कितना कृष्ण क्या करते हैं, कृष्ण क्या क्या, और साधारण कृष्ण जब जानते हैं चलिया कैसे स्त्रियों को मनानी चाहिए, तब वहाँ पर शिक्षा देते हैं जगन्नाथ जी। अगर स्त्री को मनाना चाहे तो कैसे जल्दी मना सकते, तो शिक्षा देते हैं, बोले दो चीज से आप स्त्री को संतुष्ट कर सकते हो, कितने चीज से, अरे बोलो जोर से, जगन्नाथ शिक्षा देते, अगर पत्नी अगर मान गई माने नहीं हो गए इसको कैसे तो मनाओ दो चीज से बोले क्या चीज बोले उनको लाइफ साड़ी दिया वो जैसे जैसे चाहती है ना पहनने के लिए कपड़ा बढ़िया से बढ़िया जो कपड़ा वो चाहती है पहला नंबर उनके लिए बढ़िया साड़ी ले आ और दूसरे चीज उनके लिए सोने की अलंकार उनके लिए सोने की अलंकार जो सोने की अलंकार ले आ वो दो चीज जो स्त्री है ना वो दो चीज से जल्दी खुश होते हैं जगन्नाथ जी पहले से ही वो दो चीज लेकर जाते हैं और बढ़िया रसगुल्ला स्पेशल ऑर्डर दे करके ये तीन चीज जगन्नाथ जी लेकर के आते हैं इतने में जगन्नाथ जी तो चलिया है लक्ष्मी कहती क्या हो गया इतना दिन क्यों दिए बोले मैं तो जल्दी आना चाह रहा था अरे जब विदेश में गया हूँ बिना कुछ लिए तेरे लिए थोड़ी आ सकता कुछ तो लेकर के आनी चाहिए ना हैं तेरे वजह से ले बोले मेरे वजह से क्या बोले वहां पर गया तू जो पसंद करती ना साड़ी सोने की एम्ब्रॉयडरी क्या कारीगरी वो साड़ी बनारस साड़ी मैंने ऑर्डर दिया था और वो देने में लेट कर दिया मेरा क्या दोष होता खाली हाथ से कैसे आ सकता और जानते हो तेरे लिए क्या लाया सोने के अलंकार गले से प्यार की नाक की सर की पहले स्त्रियां बहुत सारे अलंकार तेरे लिए ऑर्डर दिया था देने में लेट कर दिया मेरे क्या दोष बोले और क्या जाना जानती हो बोले क्या बोले स्पेशल रसगुल्ला तेरे लिए ऑर्डर दे कर क्या जब लक्ष्मी सुनती है ना मुंह से पानी आ जाती है गए तो गए लेकिन मेरे को उन्होंने याद किया है तब उसको बाद में कहते भैया गए थे गए लेकिन मैं याद किया दरवाजा खोल दो तर लक्ष्मी भगवान का आरती उतारती है उनको ले गए
So when Jagannath is standing at the door trying to get gain an entrance and Lakshmiji is in mom and she is not letting him enter. So Sita Maharaj is describing that Krishna is very expert. Krishna is very expert and very clever. He knows how to break a man, and he is used to breaking the man of Radharani, which is 10 times more deeper, 10 times more difficult to break than Lakshmiji. Lakshmiji's man is nothing, and Radharani's man it is so difficult. He is so expert. He has been successful in breaking man of Radharani every single time that she performs man. Sometimes she takes on the form of a mangled seller. Sometimes she takes the form of a saintly person. He is taking so many different forms. And he knows whatever he will do, he knows how to please Radharani. He knows how to break the man. And it is actually, he's saying, this is a lesson for all the husbands present here. They should also learn from this, how to break the man of your wife if she is in man, if she's annoyed at you. How to break the man? He said, the ladies, they love very, very much, they have attachment towards very nice sari. Very nice sari, and they're very deep attachment also for very nice jewelry made up of gold. And what did Krishna do, Jagannath do? Lord Jagannath, when he's coming, he's already come prepared for this. He's already come prepared. He's already come prepared. He brought a very nice sari, made up of golden, having golden jewel, golden embroidery, etc. And he has brought some very nice jewelry. In earlier days, even nowadays also in India, so many ladies, they wear jewelry from top to bottom. Some jewelry for the head, some jewelry for the necklace, some jewelry for earrings, some jewelry for the shoulder, some jewelry for the arms, etc. So, for ankles, etc. He brought so much jewelry. So, and then he comes and knocks at the door and he's asking, who is it? Oh, it is me. He said, let me enter. He said, why have you come here? Go where have you come from? He said, what do you mean by go wherever? I would have come much earlier. The problem is that I ordered something for you. I got something. I know what kind of sari you like. And I ordered that sari. And this craftsman who was supposed to make the sari, he took so long. And because he took so long, I got delayed. And then not only I got the sari, look at this golden embroidery. Embroidery made up of gold threads. Very nice, wonderful sari. I know which sari you like. I gave this special order for you. And then this jewelry. I know what kind of jewelry you like. And I have given this craftsman to make some jewelry. I ordered him. I know what kind of jewelry you like. And I ordered this jewelry to him and he took so many days. I would have come much longer. But actually, I was delayed because of you. He said, because of me. Then he made me understand that he had brought and all these things for me. And then he said, also, I have given an order for very nice rasagullas. And I have brought a big bag of rasagullas for you. And when Lakshmi hears all these things and rasagulla, of course her mouth began to water. Her mouth began to water. And he went away. He stayed away from me for so long, but he did not forget me. See, he brought so many things for me. So then she opens the door and then he offers these gifts to her.
Oh,
and then when she opens the door, And then she performs arati to the Lord, and then she welcomes him inside the palace.
महाप्रभु उन्होंने कहाँ पर रहे 18 साल तक कंटिन्यू रहेगा अरे जगन्नाथपुरी में महापुर रहे बोले कोई प्रश्न है महापुर जगन्नाथपुरी में क्यों रहे जो कि जो इच्छा वो गोलोक वृंदावन में पूरी नहीं कर पाए राधा हरि का प्रेम की क्या महिमा कृष्ण का क्या माधुर्य जिसको राधा हरि आस्वादन करती है और आस्वादन करके जो आनंद प्राप्त होता है कृष्ण से करोड़ गुण ज्यादा आनंद है जिस चीज को गोलोक वृंदावन में पूरी नहीं कर पाए वही चीज कहाँ पर किए
There is a question here that may arise that Puri is considered to be Dwaraka, but Mahaprabhu has stayed there for 18 years. Actually, this Jagannath Puri and the Rath-Yatra pastimes and all pastimes associated with the Lord Jagannath, they are very significant for the Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Now, he is asking this question. That although this is Dwaraka, but Mahaprabhu, why has he come here? What is the incarnation for? His incarnation, what it is, those desires which he could not fulfill in Goloka Vrindavan, he has come here to fulfill those desires. What are his desires? His desires were that he wants to understand what kind of affection, what attachment, how much attachment she has for Krishna, and how does she relish, and what kind of prayer she has for me, what are the glories of her prayer? So he wants to relish all these, he wants to understand all this, and that is why he has come here. So in these 18 years that he stayed here, he has relished all those desires, he has fulfilled all those desires with which he had come to fulfill on this planet Earth. And how?
कहते महाप्रभु कौन और जगन्नाथ जी कौन है इसलिए जगन्नाथ जी की वैशिष्ट को गौरव महाराज देखते थे कहते जो महाप्रभु है कौन है ये अभी ये राधा रानी है कहते ये राधा रानी जो है वो कहते कृष्ण को ढूंढ रही लेकिन जो जगन्नाथ जी है वो जगन्नाथ जी का ये रूप क्यों धारण किया जगन्नाथ जी को तो राधा रानी की प्रेम ने ये जगन्नाथ जी का रूप धारण किया राधा जी प्रेम में जगन्नाथ जी कहते हैं राधा विधुरा और कृष्ण विधुरा मतलब एक राधा जी को ढूंढ रही है और एक कृष्ण को ढूंढ रहे महापुरुष ढूंढ रहे हैं कृष्ण को जगन्नाथ जी इसको ढूंढ राधा राधा जी प्रेम को देख करके जगन्नाथ इसलिए कहते जगन्नाथ का जो विग्रह है राधा विधुरा जो राधा जी प्रेम में ये रूप धारण किया इसलिए महापुरुष और कहीं नहीं रहे और महापुरुष जो आस्वादन करने के लिए आते थे राधा जी के प्रेम इसलिए उन्होंने पूरी
So, Pujvachala Bhagavan Maharaj has given very nice explanation about why, although he came to Puri Mahaprabhu, and although he had come to relish the glories of Radharani's prayer, etc., and he said in Puri, why did he say? He's describing that who is Mahaprabhu? Mahaprabhu is actually Krishna, but in the mood of Radharani. In the mood of Radharani means he is always searching for Krishna. This is the Mahaprabhu's mood. And who is Lord Jagannath? Lord Jagannath is Krishna himself, but he has taken on this form. So his form is melted in this form because of his separation from Radharani. So means Krishna, Lord Jagannath is Radha Vidura, means he is searching for Radharani. And Mahaprabhu is Krishna Vidura, means he is searching for Krishna. So because they are hanging for each other, that is why those desires which he had come to fulfill there, Mahaprabhu was able to fulfill these pastimes, these desires in Puri. So Pujvachala Bhagavan Maharaj has given this explanation.
इसलिए कहते हैं ये जगन्नाथ जी एक क्यों ऐसे हो गए? शास्त्र में तीन चार कारण हैं। एक कारण तो जो 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 लकड़ी का जो लकड़ी आया था उसको बोले 21 दिन तक इसको बंद करके रखो जो अनंत महाराणा आया था उसको बना देना इसलिए 24 दिन में खोल दिए, इसलिए जब नाग देखा ऐसे आधा हाथ में आँख है इसे पूरा बनाने, ये बाहर दाग है, ये मुख्य दाग नहीं है, ये साधारण दाग है, लेकिन केदारनाथ के मुख्य दाग वही कारण है, उसको और कुछ नहीं मिलता इसके ऊपर में। दूसरा कारण हमारे बृहद भागवत अमृतम में सनातन गोस्वामी जो वर्णन करते हैं, जब ब्रज की कथा सुनते 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 कृष्ण क्या हो गया, कृष्ण स्वयं ब्रज की गर्भभूत रूप धारण किया है, ये ब्रज कथा सुनते सुनते। लेकिन हमारे गौरवानंद महाराज ने उन्होंने हम कोई बहुत पुरानी जो ग्रंथ है हमारी जो उड़ीसा के बहुत पुरानी ग्रंथ है उससे उन्होंने ढूंढ करके निकाले ये कैसे जगन्नाथ जी ने कैसे धारण किया, राधा जी के गृह को देखते कैसे ये गर्भ ऋतु है, ये चीज जो उन्होंने जो निकाले सभी जो सर्वश्रेष्ठ कारण यही कारण है। इसलिए जब महाराज जी इसको सुने महाराज एक हृदय की बात नहीं महाराज बहुत खुश होते इसलिए महाराज जी प्रकाश ने क्या ग्रहण करना है।
He's describing that how Mahaprabhu is in this mood and Mahaprabhu has waiting. Mahaprabhu is performing this pastime for which it is described that he is from Goloka Vrindavan and he stayed there. Now, there are many reasons why Lord Jagannath has taken on this form. It is described there are few reasons. One of the reasons that is described is that Anant Maharaj, the so this is how we know that how the wooden blocks they have floated around the ocean and they have collected and all of them have touched the shore at Chakrati. They touched there and then because Indradum Maharaj had gotten this dream that I will come and you craft me out into the form of Krishna. So then the king got this dream and then these wooden pieces arrived and then we know that these pieces were taken, these piece of wood, heavy block of wood, they were taken and nobody could even actually, any hammer, any chisel that was used on this piece of wood, they were shattered to pieces. Nobody could even scratch this piece of wood. So in the end, there came a very old artisan who came and he said, I can carve these deities. And then, but he said, my condition is that I will make it for 21 days, I will work all alone and nobody should open this door where I will be working. I will work in a solitary place. So he worked for 14 days, but after 14 days, there were no sound coming from the room. And the king and the queen, Indradyumna and his wife, they became worried. They were thinking that he was an old man and he actually is all alone. And now, earlier, every day they used to hear the loud bangs of the hammer and chisel, etc. But now there is no banging, no sound is heard from the door. They are putting their ears on the door, everybody, but they can't hear not a single scratch of a sound also they cannot hear. And they cannot hear the sound, they begin to get worried. They begin to think that if now we do not pay attention to what is happening to this Brahman who had come, we will incur the wrath of Brahman Hatha. Means we will be responsible for the death of a Brahman. They became worried, so they opened the door. And that time when they opened the door, they saw that the deities were carved, but they were carved, some form had carved roughly, but the hands were unfinished, the nose was unfinished, the eyes were unfinished, and his face was unfinished. And this is the manifested form that they saw. And they became very, very worried. So he's describing in Orissa, actually, generally people know only about this much, they know only about the deities, this much facts, they know only this much. They're saying there is a more confidential reason in this. A more confidential reason it is described in and also Purvashila. Gauravani Maharaj also has described the internal reason. The internal reason is described. And not that he is. It's not that he is speaking from the concoction of his mind. No. He searched out a very old scripture, and from this scripture he is quoted. It's from the scripture he is quoting why Lord Jagannath has taken on this form. Lord Jagannath, in hearing the pastimes of Radharani and the Brajavasis, he like wax, he melted. he his heart became so affected by this katha of having the darshan of Radharani's prem, he sort of started melting. And this is when Krishna started melting, this is the form that was manifest. This was the form that was there. So Pujvashala Gaurav Maharaj has described this pastime. He has described this pastime, and when Gurudev heard this, what Pujvashala Gaurav Maharaj explained about the form of Radharani, our Gurudev became very happy. He said, oh, this is the pastime that is very close and very dear to my heart. We became very happy. And he published this pastime from Pujvashala Gaurav Maharaj in his books also.
इसलिए सबसे बड़ा जो फेस्टिवल है महाप्रभु अगर किसी सबसे बड़ा फेस्टिवल में अगर सारे महाप्रभु का परिवार एकत्र तो किसी लीला में तो एक लीला देखोगे तो जगन्नाथ जी रथ यात्रा लीला में सारे बताए गए महापुरुष स्वयं जिस रथ यात्रा को स्वयं महापुरुष स्वयं रथ को कहते थे और अपना परिक्रम बोले थे साथ साथ दल भजन का कीर्तन बोले थे महाप्रभु पूरा जगन्नाथ रथ यात्रा को अगर सबसे बढ़िया रूप में कोई ये किया था महाप्रभु ने किया और महाप्रभु कई तरह के साथ में किया.
So if you look at all the festivals in the world, you will see actually Jagannath Rath Yatra is the biggest festival. The collection of people that there are in one single this festival is cannot be compared to any other festival. All those people who have gone to Rath Yatra, raise your hand. Jagannath. So all those people who have been to Rath Yatra, they know that there are millions and literally millions of people on a single span of
road. स्त्रियां तो छू नहीं सकती रसी को चार चार एक रथ में चार बार रसी होता है और कितने बड़ी होती है इतने मोटी होती है स्त्रियां तो छू नहीं सकती पुरुषों को भी हम लोग को छूने के लिए कठिन होता है रसी को मतलब इतने बड़ों को मार बनता
है. He said that the chariot and the sword, every chariot has four ropes and each rope is thick like a trunk of an elephant and the people are pulling it and those who have been to this festival and those who have tried to pull the rope it is so difficult. You cannot even think of some lady pulling. If you cannot even imagine that lady will be able to enter into that such a thick crowd, they cannot enter. It's impossible, next to impossible. Even for us to go, we were there also. It is, oh my God, it is like waves and waves of people coming, waves and waves of people trying to touch. It just, they think that they will just, they have this faith, if they will even just touch that rope, they will, it will be so auspicious for them. Everybody is trying to move towards the Rath Yatra. It is, and these ropes, it is showing that they are half a kilometer long. And every chariot is being pulled by each chariot, like four ropes. So there are 12 ropes that are pulling all these chariots, and such a huge festival, such a celebration, impossible to describe in words actually. This is all the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, they would join together only in one place or at one time simultaneously in Jagannath Rath Yatra. And when Mahaprabhu used to perform his pastime in Jagannath Rath Yatra, then all the associates of Mahaprabhu, they would come there and they would perform this pastime together. So now also all the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, they go and they perform this pastime together in a collective manner.
Okay. Mm-hmm. रथे वामन दृष्टा पुनर्जन्म नदी देते रथ रूप एक बार जगन्नाथ को कोई दर्शन करता है फिर दो बार उसका जन्म नहीं होता एक बार अगर उसको दर्शन किया तो क्योंकि जगन्नाथ जी रथ यात्रा के ऊपर बैठते हैं बैठते समय वो हमारे उड़ीसा देश में माताएं कहा करती थी जो स्त्रियाँ गर्भवती होती थी ना बोलते थे जगन्नाथ जी रथ यात्रा देखने मत जाया करो बोले क्यों बोले जगन्नाथ जी के आँख इतने इतने बड़े हैं ना एक बार रथ को जो दर्शन करते हैं उनका इतनी कृपा दृष्टि रहती है इतने वो प्रसन्न रहते हैं जो एक बार दर्शन कर लेना कहते ऊपर तो प्रभाव पड़ता है पेट में जो बच्चा है ना उसको ऊपर में प्रभाव पड़ता है जब उसको आंख बड़ी बड़ी हो जाएगी गर्भवती हो जाए मतलब ऐसे जगन्नाथ जी रथ यात्रा का समय में ऐसे कृपा दृष्टि मिल जाती है.
At least once in your lifetime, at least everybody should go and visit the Rath Yatra. This Rath Yatra is so auspicious, he's describing Punarjanmana Vidyate. Anybody who has darshan of this Rath Yatra once in their lifetime, understand they will not take birth again. He said, it is so famous, this pastime, and everybody knows about this pastime, that he described that when Lord Jagannath is riding on the chariot, he is very merciful. He has very merciful glance. He is, if you will go and visit this festival, you see he's like a drunken person. He's tossing like this, and that. He's tossing up and down, and backwards and forward he's tossing. And he's, again, wherever, whoever he sees, he casts a very merciful glance. You should describe that in our Orissa, it is very famous, that especially those ladies who are pregnant, they should not go and have darshan of Rath Yatra. Why? He's saying because Lord Jagannath has such big eyes, and he is so powerful, his influence is so powerful, what to speak about those ladies who are pregnant, they will be affected definitely by this having darshan of this pastime. That child who is in the womb, he will also be affected. They're saying if you go and have darshan of this Lord Jagannath riding on the chariot, his eyes will also become very big. So you don't want a child with such abnormal eyes. Don't go and have darshan.
जगन्नाथ जी का वहाँ जो भोग लगाते हैं ना विश्राम स्मृति बंद करके मत करते ऐसे नहीं रात जितने दूर से दिखता है उतना दूर से पंडित जय जगन्नाथ ऐसे करके ग्रहण करते
हैं. He is describing that how we are we know that some etiquettes are there in offering, that we close the door, we offer tulsi, we chant mantras, etc., and then you leave it for some time, and then it is considered as offered. He's saying when the Lord is riding the chariot, there is no such etiquette. There are no such rules or regulations. Till from wherever you can see Lord Jagannath, just raise whatever you have in your hand so that he is able to see. Till the chariot can see this offering and the offering can see the chariot. Just put a tulsi leaf on this and offer it. Jai Jagannath, and it is considered as offered. So he is so merciful. Till where his glance is going, everything is considered as offered.
Jagannath ji, जगन्नाथ जी इतना खुश क्यों रहते, क्योंकि जगन्नाथ जी को ब्रज में जा रहे हैं ना गोपियों से ब्रजवासियों से मिलने के लिए. इसलिए सबसे आनंद समय है जो राधा रानी से मिलने के लिए चले जाए, इसलिए वो इतने खुश रहते हैं. इसमें जो उसकी मावर जो कर जगन्नाथ जी की छापुर कर देते हैं.
जैसे
कोई व्यक्ति को जब कहते हैं देख सुनकर मांगनी चाहिए, अगर उसका मूड जो बढ़िया हो ना उसी समय मांगे, क्रोध मूड में नहीं. उनका मूड क्यों बढ़िया है, ब्रजवासी राधा राम से मिलने के लिए जा रहे हैं, मूड अच्छा है, इसलिए जो प्रसन्न होकर जगन्नाथ दर्शन देते हैं.
So Lord Jagannath is described here that he is very magnificent, he is very merciful when he is riding this chariot. Why is he so happy? Why is he so merciful at this time of the chariot ride? It is described that where is he going now? He is going to Braj. To meet whom? He is going to meet Radharani and all the other Brajvasis. Because he is going to meet Brajvasis and Radharani and other devotees or other associates of his from Braj, for whom he has deep affection and they have deep affection for him. So he is very happy that he is going to meet them. Because when he is very happy, so he is very merciful also. It is said, if a person is clever, he should understand, he should see. If you want to ask something from somebody, you should see what his mood is. If he is in good mood, and then you ask him, he will give you whatever you want. If he's in bad mood, better not ask him anything. So now,
इसलिए स्त्रियाँ पति से कब जब बहुत ज़्यादा सेवा करते हैं पत्नी पति को पता चलता है कि गड़बड़ी होगी. कितना भी कर जरूर कुछ मांगेंगे, क्योंकि सेवा कर रहे हैं ना, जब आप जरूर मांगी पता चल जाती है. जब उस समय पत्नी अब खुश करेगी ना, चाहती है ऐसे अगर बता तो अब क्या होता है, ठीक कर सकते फिर पति हो जाती है.
Ladies also, when the ladies are serving a lot, because if they have some desire, if they want to get something from their husband, what do they start serving their husbands? Day and night, they're serving every fulfilling, every desire of his. They serve even more than usual. And when they're serving like this, the husband also begins to understand that definitely she's going to ask something of him. And when she's serving like this, then the husband eventually asks, what is it? What do you want? She says like, oh, I want this, I want to, maybe you can do this, maybe you can give this and all. So similarly, when Lord Jagannath is riding the chariot, he is in very good mood. He is like an intoxicant. He is in very good mood. He is very happy. He is tossing, turning, everything. He is restless and he wants to reach that place very quickly. And whoever will come and ask anything, he will fulfill their desire.
जगन्नाथ जी रथ यात्रा, महाप्रभु स्वयं अपना हाथों से जगन्नाथ जी रथ को स्वयं महाप्रभु अपने हाथों से खींचते हैं. इसलिए कभी कभी महाप्रभु राधा जी के भाव में रथ यात्रा क्या है, रथ यात्रा उसको कहते हैं, अभी अभी कुरुक्षेत्र में बहुत दिन को बाद में जब सूर्य ग्रहण हुआ, पूर्ण सूर्य ग्रहण हुआ, हाँ जो पूर्ण का सूर्य ग्रहण में सबके सब कुरुक्षेत्र जाते हैं, हाँ? कुरुक्षेत्र में वहाँ पर ब्रह्म हृदय ना स्नान करने के लिए जाते हैं, इसलिए एक समय पूरा पूर्ण सूर्य ग्रहण हुआ। सूर्य ग्रहण होने पर सारा दुनिया का लोग आए कुरुक्षेत्र में, कुरुक्षेत्र में सारा दुनिया लोग आए, उसमें ब्रजवासी भी आए, नंद यशोदा सब ब्रजवासी आए, और कृष्ण द्वारका से भी आए, तो जो स्थान प्रसिद्ध स्थान, वहाँ स्नान करने से दान पुण्य करने से पाप खत्म हो जाती है, पाप खत्म हो जाती, सारे ब्रजवासी वहाँ पर आए और कृष्ण भी आए। जब कृष्ण आए इतने में कृष्ण को पता चला मेरे ब्रजवासी राधा रानी नंद यशोदा मेरे सखा सखियाँ भी यहाँ पर आई, इसलिए कृष्ण उनसे मिलने के लिए बड़े उत्कंठा, क्यों 100 साल हो गया आपको दर्शन नहीं हुआ, अब मिले नहीं, कृष्ण गए तो मथुरा मथुरा द्वारा चले गए, मिले नहीं। इतने में जब कृष्ण ब्रजवासियों से राधा रानी से मिले, उसी समय में राधा रानी कह रही है, श्याम सुंदर आप भी वही कृष्ण हो, मैं भी वही राधा हूँ, लेकिन जब हम वृंदावन में जमुना किनारे में मिलते थे, कुंज में जब मिलते थे, जहाँ पर जमुना कलकल नाद से बह रही है, जहाँ पर सुंदर चंद्रमा की चांदनी, हाँ चांदनी ये कर रही है, जहाँ पर जूली बेली चमेली बड़े सुंदर फूल खिल रहा है, हैं? उसी समय जो हम जमुना किनारे में हम दोनों मिलते थे, कुंज में वो जो आनंद होता था, यहाँ पर तो आपका जो वेश है वो राज वेश है, कोई आपकी ब्रज वेश है ही नहीं, राज वेश है, और यहाँ पर घोड़ा गाड़ी सैन्य सामर्थ, यहाँ पर तो भावी नहीं आ रही। अगर आप हमें खुश करना चाहते हो, हमारे हृदय रूपी रथ में आप बैठो, आप तो हम ले जाएंगे कहाँ वृंदावन, वृंदावन में जो निकुंज में वृंदावन में मिलेंगे तभी मेरे का आनंद होगा। इसीलिए कहते रथ यात्रा नहीं, राधा रानी अपना हृदय रूपी रथ में श्याम सुंदर को बैठा करके कुरुक्षेत्र से वृंदावन ये रथ यात्रा।
So we know that how Mahaprabhu is performing this rasa and what the Jari festival is performing, and it's performing this in such an elaborate manner. He divides the devotees into 7 parties. Every party has so many vridangas, all the vridanga players, all the dancers are there, and he is dancing, performing this in such a beautiful mood. Why? Well, what is the meaning of this? What is he doing, Mahaprabhu? He's describing that there was a time when Krishna has gone from Braj, and from Braj he had gone to Mathura, and he said that I will come back within a few days. But now from Mathura he went further to Dwaraka, but he did not return to Vrindavan. He could not return to Vrindavan. And now after 100 years there is a solar eclipse, a total solar eclipse. When it is solar eclipse, it is considered as inauspicious. So when it is inauspicious, what do you do? You take bath in the holy rivers. So at Kurukshetra they decided to converge, and all the people from all over the
world.
Parashuram, when he had made the earth devoid of Kshatriyas 21 times, at that time he considered himself that he had performed so many sinful activities. So because he had performed so many sinful activities, so he decided to perform austerities for all the mitigating all these sinful reactions. So he stayed in Kurukshetra, Parashuram, and he performed austerities. And there Brahmaji made a very wonderful pond, very wonderful kund he made, and where it is understood that Parashuram took bath and he could mitigate himself from all these sinful reactions of killing all the Kshatriyas. So all these people also, because there is a being a total solar eclipse, and then they decide to converge in Kurukshetra, where they will take bath in this pond, and by taking this pond, they will be able to free themselves from all, any inauspiciousness that has occurred on them. So everybody comes there, Krishna also comes there, and the Brajavasis also come there. When they come there, when Krishna understands that the Brajavasis are here, and then he wants to meet them. And then he wants to meet them, then he meets them, but Radharani says there. Radharani says, you are the same Krishna, and I am the same Radharani who used to meet at the banks of the river. But what is missing here is that atmosphere. We used to have the beautiful moonlight, moonlit nights. We used to have all the wonderful, beautiful jewels available, etc. Flowers, and there were so beautiful birds who were singing such beautiful, sweet songs. And that atmosphere is missing. He's saying, if you really want to make me happy, then come on, take a ride on the chariot of my heart, and I will take you to Vrindavan, where we will be able to perform our pastimes as sweetly as we used to perform earlier. So understand this chariot festival is because he's staying in Dwarka. So he's staying in Dwarka. So Radharani is taking Krishna on this chariot of her heart, and she's taking him to Vrindavan. He's saying, tomorrow we will try to hear why Lord Jagannath has taken this form. Why has he made this form? We'll try to hear this form.
Okay.
हरे कृष्णा
जगन्नाथ जी ब्रज प्रेम में एकदम डूबे हुए हैं तो कृष्णा जगन्नाथ जी बेहोश हो गए राधा रानी प्रेम में जब उनको नारद जी के भजन के आज जगन्नाथ कृष्णा उठे उस समय में पूरा राधा जी प्रेम में वो डूब गए थे सारा जो किया ना सारा जो देखो
जी
वो जगन्नाथ जी राधा रानी के प्रेम से शराब को पान कर रहे
This is asking this question that when Lord Jagannath is brought to ride on the chariot, that time he is sort of brought as if he's shaken enough. Maharaj is saying that he's not shaken. He himself is shaking like this. Just like think about somebody who is intoxicated himself with some alcohol the night before. So the entire night he is like walking, he's not able to walk straight. He's walking in crooked steps, he's walking in a drunken manner. So similarly, Krishna is also drunk on Radharani's brain. And the alcohol that somebody may drink for intoxication, that effect will be finished by the morning. Maybe a little hangover, otherwise nothing will suit it. But if somebody gets intoxicated, Krishna gets intoxicated on Radharani's brain, that is such which the intoxication doesn't become less, it increases. So that's why when he is coming, he is like as if a drunk person, as if totally intoxicated in Radharani's brain, he's coming moving like this, like a totally drunk person, intoxicated.